What's up, Zombie Slayers? This is KJ48, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single-player Let's Play. We are in Episode 9, and I am here in my base during the night. We are going to begin staying here during the night. I have been doing some work, so let me show you what I've been up to. By the way, this base does have a name now. I'm going to call it the Morning Star Outpost. Why? I don't know. Morning Star, the Morning Star I kind of like because it kind of makes me think of, like, I don't know, like the beginning. The beginning. So, I kind of like the Morning Star because this is the beginning. This is the first base. This is the beginning defense for the Let's Play, and I kind of like that. I don't know. I think it sounds kind of cool. So, let's go up here and show you the layout I've been doing up here. I've got a setup. I'm going to need some more torches. Well, we don't have the torches, so we're just going to use this this thing for now. Alright, so, this is the layout. I have set this up, so we are covered in case the zombies get in. My plan is to defend down below, defend down below, defend down below, and then eventually, if I feel that the walls are going to give and I can't hold it, I'm going to come up here and fight from above, fight from above, fight from above. Now, if they're attacking my walls here, I've got them all set up with this overhang system. You know, I tried to make it look pretty cool. You know, even though these things are structurally sound, even though they're not actually connected to this block, they are in a way. I still wanted extra structural integrity just for the looks and, you know, I don't know, just to make myself feel good. They can still get up over here. There's not the screamers, but the spider zombies. So we're going to have to put something over there, but I'm not going to do that right now. Or maybe I will. I don't know. We'll see. But, so you see what I've done up there, and you're going to see what I've done down here as well. I've dug down quite a bit. I'm not sure how far I'm going to dig, but I do have this area marked right here. That is, at least 4 or 5 patches of gravel. So when I do get down to my desired, you know, area, I'm going to dig this way. So I think that's pretty much bringing you up to speed. I did move some stuff over here. You notice my wellness is really high. I actually made meat stew. Meat stew is just ridiculous. So pretty sweet, pretty sweet. All right, so let's continue building here. It's really nice. I love this part of the game when I can work on my base during the night. That really makes me happy. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. Okay. Are we going to need more of these concrete? I don't know what I want to put over here for an overhang. I really don't want to use concrete, to be honest. Honestly, I don't know what I'm going to do for over there. If I put concrete right here, I guess I could do that. But then if I walk over this, it's going to look like I could walk over this. But if I do, I'm just going to fall. So I'm not really sure. I might use concrete there. If I don't use concrete, I don't know what else I would use to keep spider zombies from coming up. I do have some ideas, but nothing that'll match the build. I should probably just use these. All right, you know what? Forget it. Let's just use these. We're committed to the quarter block, so let's just do it. I cut down a bunch of trees. I'm making a bunch more spikes. I've come to the conclusion that I'm going to let these spikes get broken out. These wooden spikes, okay? I used wood to get these spikes down. As of right now, if I break these spikes up, the only thing I've lost is the wood that I put into them. I can also put down those metal spikes. And the thing is with these wooden spikes, if I upgrade these, it's going to cost me wood to upgrade them, which sucks. I'm going to lose wood, but not really that big of a deal, but still, I don't want to lose wood. But it's also going to cost me 20 iron to get it to the first iron stage of the wood stage. Like, wood goes, you put down the spike, it goes wood stage, iron stage. So there is an iron stage in there, and I would be throwing away 20 iron per spike. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave the spikes the way they are. We're going to let the 14-day horde tear some of them up, and then I'm going to rip the rest up with my axe, and I'm going to place down the other spikes. In the long run, it's going to, for every spike I rip up and place one down, it's going to save me 20 iron. So I hope that makes sense to you guys. It's a little confusing, I know, but when it's a time to tear those up, I will explain it to you in more detail. All right, so this thing is now safe. So we've got to make that part safe. So should we make another... Should we make more blocks going over there? Probably should. Will they line up properly? Yes, they will. Just like that. Try and also make this look good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm trying not to... hold this down for any more than 5 clicks, because if I do, it's going to upgrade it to reinforced concrete, and I really don't want to waste my concrete. This stuff does not need to be reinforced concrete up here. All right, so I'm thinking one there. Nope, didn't mean to do that. One there, and I guess just one there is fine. Okay. Yeah, we're going to make it so if we come up here, then the zombies are really screwed. All right, so how do I want to do this? So I can go there. We could probably put in... Well, we could just put one of these in there. Yeah, it'll just make it easier to do it like that. We are using a lot of concrete here. One would say that iron is probably easier to get than concrete. I understand that, but... Well, I don't know. I guess it is, but... I like this build. I'd rather use the concrete. I want to save the iron, because I'm telling you, we're going to need a lot of iron for those spikes. A lot of iron. Okay. So that will protect that area. Do you guys see any place that the spider zombies can get up here? I think I've pretty much, like, protected the whole area from spider zombies. That's what this overhang thing is all about. It actually looks pretty good. Except for this part, because it doesn't have any blocks, but it doesn't need any either. I don't know, I kind of think it looks pretty good, to be honest. I wonder. Let's see if we can... This is just off the cuff. I want to see if I can use some of these wood railings. Yeah, I can. I could probably make real good use out of these wood railings. But I'm not going to do it because I'm just going to have to be careful. This isn't about a cosmetic build. This is about being, like, shooting down. I mean, those railings... Actually, I think you could shoot through these. Oh, I'm getting cold. I think you could shoot through those railings. I probably should put some railings down. I won't yet. Not yet. Maybe later. I purposely left some stuff over here in case I got cold. There we go. And that's all we need. Yeah, because like you guys told me in the comments, thank you very much. The leather duster will keep you from getting wet. So it's not quite a raincoat, but yeah, I mean, that's the way leather works. It's leather is very smooth on the outside, so the water just kind of rolls off you. Good job, pimps. Good job. All right, we're going to need some more of these, aren't we? Yeah, let's make another 25. I really don't want to make more than I need, though. There's not much point in that. Let's make another 15. I know we're going to need 15. Oh, put another concrete. There we go. Man, we're really running out of concrete. That's what I'm saying, man. This is taking a lot of concrete. That's a bummer. But still, we're saving the iron. It's one or the other. I don't think either way is better than the other. I'm just, you know, I basically want to do something different than iron bars, I guess. You know, it's just something different, right? I mean, that's always a welcome change. So... You know, if you want to just mine more iron, you know, that's cool. I'll mine more stone, you know. The iron is probably just as effective. You know, I don't know if I'm being quite clear on what I'm talking about here. Basically, the idea is that in order to do these overhangs, you're either going to use a lot of iron or a lot of stone. I always use iron on these. The iron bars take a lot of iron, tons of iron. But what I'm doing right now is taking a ton of concrete. It's robbing Peter to pay Paul, you know, it's one or the other, you know, so you can use a lot of iron or a lot of concrete. Normally I would just use a lot of iron, just to keep this Let's Play. A lot of people have been claiming in the comments that I've, been doing the same builds and maybe I need to get more creative, and well, just consider this as me being a little more creative. And my spikes are going to be boss. They're going to be upgraded to steel, 10,000 hit points. It's going to be awesome. Okay. Man, why am I leveling? I'm not even doing anything. Not that I'm complaining, but... Alright, so... And then some right here. So it looks like the front is just about good. We are on day 13. By the way, guys, I actually got a dog horde on day 12, but I was in my base. It was only like 3 or 4 dogs. They ran up to the spikes and they got automatically killed. So I didn't think it was anything worth, you know, recording. All right. There. 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 And there. See, the only thing I don't like about this is it's going to make me think I can walk across here, and I can't. And that could be a little, you know... It could get me in some trouble, we'll say. Oh, crap. I didn't want to do that. Well, maybe I do. Yeah, whatever. We'll do this one like this. It doesn't... it looks okay. It's fine. I don't want to put another block here because I feel like this is already going to be hard to shoot down if I have to. Like, if they break in and I have to shoot down from this angle, it's already a little bit difficult. I don't want to put another block right there. So we're probably going to need another 15, probably. Okay. Oh, that's it. Come on, man. Build faster. Well, we could go cut down some trees, I guess. Or, what do we want to do? What do we want to do during the day? Oh, I think we want to hit boulders, actually. I didn't get a chance to get any boulders yesterday, so let's go bang up some boulders and wait for this stuff, and you know, we'll come back and do some building. We're probably going to be building during the day. Normally, I like to farm during the day and build at night, but you know, that's not going to really be the case. So let's go ahead and eat another one of these stews. All right, the stews warm you up, and I'm going to drop some stuff off, and I'll see you out at the boulder field, people. Okay, guys, I'm kind of getting a little pushed for time here, so I just skipped the whole boulder thing. I just went off camera, and this is what I came up with. Lumps of clay, bunch of iron, a bunch of stone, killed a couple zombies, got a little couple drops here and there. I'm going to head back. I'm going to put the potassium nitrate in, I'm going to put the potassium nitrate and the coal in the chem station, and I'm going to have that start making gunpowder, and then I'm going to work on the crossbow. I totally forgot about the crossbow. I should also start working on my weapon skills again. I haven't really had time to do it because it's been crunch time, go this whole time. So, but I think a crossbow would be really nice. I don't know how many feathers I have. I'm gonna have to make some iron head thingies, arrowheads, and yeah. So that's the plan. And I gotta fill this in at some point as well, so that they don't start digging in there. And I also made a bunch of these wood spikes. I think I might make some barbed wire for day 14. I'm gonna have to think about that. Okay, guys, I'm going to do some looting here. I've got some stuff being made back at the house, and I figured doing some looting would be a nice way to break it up a little bit. I'm also looking for gun parts, so gun safes would be a nice way to go here. I know that the prison has gun safes, so I'm going to loot the prison, but I figured I'd loot this building as well because I think this building has gun safes. Unfortunately, I did not clear up my inventory, so I'm going to have to be quite select on what I take here, but that is okay. Not really that big of a deal. Let's break in this bad boy. Alright, this won't even take that long. So, yeah, we gotta get the shotgun. I'm not gonna need the shotgun for day 14, but I do wanna... I have to have the shotgun for day 21 and on. And, you know, I figure might as well do some looting now. We have not done a lot of looting in this Let's Play. I'm trying to do too much looting because people don't seem to like it, but I do have to do some looting, so it's gonna have to happen sooner or later. That is nice right there. But I did not get the... What part do... Oh, I need the barrel. That's right. I may be able to put some of this together to make some room. Okay. Yeah, we're probably going to have to do a drop-off chest. I don't want to be throwing stuff around. Do I have a drop-off chest next to me? No, but my base is actually kind of close. Oh, yeah, there's a drop-off chest right there. Let's go hit that drop-off chest, then we'll continue looting. That was actually a pretty interesting drop-off chest. Nothing really that great in it, but some stuff. I totally forgot it was there. Alright. Now, I don't normally like looting this stuff at this point in the game, but whatever. It'll get my scavenging up. Give me a little bit of stuff here and there. Give me some canned food. So, you know, I do have a farm going. I've not shown you guys the farm, but I have been working the farm. Usually every, like, 2 days, things just seem to be ready. I'm not sure if it's ready before then, and I'm just not paying enough attention or what. But, yeah, I usually go there every... Oh, that's nice. It's not nice. Usually go there every couple days, and there's usually something there for me. I think next time I go to the farm, maybe I'll do it with you guys on camera, just to let you know how, you know, just farming. But ooh, oh, yes, sir, I will take that machete. I got a machete. We should take this thing apart while we're here, right? We're gonna need the parts anyway, so let's do that now. Yeah, we need those. We need those mechanical parts. Eventually I'll be able to make them, but I can't right now, so starting to heat up, so we'll take the duster off, and, yeah, okay, let's break into the prison. And then once we're done breaking into prison, I think we're just going to grab everything from our first base and go to the Morningstar outpost. And, yeah, probably, you know, do our thing. I don't think there's any point in breaking into this, and I'm probably going to have to drop some stuff off anyway, so let me hit up the drop-off chest. All right, guys, the good old prison. Pretty sure I know exactly where to go in this place. For the gun chest, they're kind of like down below. I might miss some things in here, but I'm gonna go for the stuff I know where it is. Oh shit, I forgot about that. Ah, crap. Oh crap. And we don't have our mini bike with us. Is our mini bike on the way? Kind of. Damn, man. You know, I never pay attention to these freaking airdrops, man. I had it written down. Yeah, pay attention to airdrops. I wrote it on my notepad. Oh, boy. Might be able to get the mini bike, but I'm not going to... I want to keep this thing on my radar, so... Yeah, so I'll see you guys at the airdrop. How the hell am I supposed to get down there? Well, I'll have to go out for that some other time. Airdrop. Yeah, kind of in that area. I'll have to figure out a way to get there at some other time. I'm too busy right now. I'll hop on the mini bike, probably take a trip around or, I don't know, kind of figure it out. It looks like it's a really hard place to get to. It looks like there's supposed to be a road going down there, but it's kind of messed up. Does that look like another town over there? That's another town over there, guys. You know what? I'm probably going to have to come down around here and then come up around here, and I think there's another town there. You can kind of see it off there in the distance. So that's interesting. All right, back to the prison. Okay. So these things are downstairs, by the way. There's one... There should be some boxes in here. Come on, switch the axe, bro. There we go. Oh! Jesus. Almost broke the damn thing. Let's go ahead and repair it. Whatever, I ain't afraid of you zombies. Okay, I was gonna break down the walls ahead of time, but there is nothing in this one. This is just like the shower room. So, not too much in here. But the other one has a wall safe and a regular safe. So, let's break this one out. Loot it up. Pistol book. Yeah. Read that. Hunting rifle. A lot of people love the hunting rifle. I'm not a huge fan, but it's okay. It's a good gun. It's okay. Alright, I was breaking this bad boy. Come on, give me a freaking shotgun barrel, game. What's your problem, game? Is this AK or pistol? It's pistol. Okay. Alright, there might be other stuff in this prison, I'm not really sure, but that's the main room that I liked. I'm gonna just go back now, and we gotta do some more building, so... Let's get back and get some more building done, besides this place is getting a lot of zombies. Actually, I do know one more room I want to break into. Really gotta work on my weapon smithing. Really badly. That's not bad. Alright, let's break in this other room, and then we're gonna get to some building. Okay. Don't care about that. I know a zombie's coming in, but whatevs. Let's just break in the safe and close the video, get to some building. I wanna get that tower done today. And then I'm gonna start digging underground and make a little place for me to put all my stuff. Then we're gonna move into the Morningstar outpost. Whoa. Man, she had like dual strike or something. Okay, let's do this. Another stupid pistol book. Alright, see you back at base. Hey guys, nighttime. I spent the night just setting up crossbow bolts, cooking stuff over at my other base. Just like, you know, basic mundane stuff, trying to get more concrete and all that kind of goodies. So let's go ahead and finish these walkways up, and then let's go ahead and build this damn thing. I pretty much have everything set in my mind on how I want to build it, so we should be pretty good to go. Take that. You know, one thing I should have got from the from the prison was the spotlights. The spotlights have gotten like nerfed or something. I don't know. They kind of suck now, but still they're free. So you know, they might suck, but you know, if they're free, I'll, you know, use them as much as I can. All right, so this is now done. I think this looks pretty good. Maybe put some banisters here around the parts I can fall. I'm not really sure, but yeah, this place is pretty much done. I also need a hatch for that. I believe the hatch is down here somewhere. There it is. And we're going to take the support beams as well. I'm going to take some more of these, and I think that's all I need for now. We need to move everything over here because I'm starting to get confused on where stuff is, which base. So I need to get stuff over here to the Morning Star Outpost. I know a lot of you guys probably hate that name, but I don't care. I love it. All right, so let's do this. We need to get some height here. And then we just put these down like so. Nah, I had it, damn it. Curve part out. There you go. 3, 4. Is 4 high enough? I don't know. Let's take a look at what these things look like. I want the support beams to be in here like that. No, it's got to be a little bit higher. Well, maybe. No, actually, that is, I think that's perfect, actually. Let's, we gotta make some more of the other pieces. I don't know if I have what I need. I don't. I need more plant fibers. I should have more down here. Oh, boy. The inventory is a mess. It needs to be sorted. Alright, so, I could have swore I had one. Yeah, there we go. One. we're almost there, people. Alright, so let's go ahead and put some of these down. Finish this thing up, close that so nobody falls down and hurts themselves. You know, we can't be responsible for people falling down and hurting their legs. Especially me. I can't be responsible for hurting my own legs, damn it. Oh, I put these down wrong. Damn it. Why you do that, Cage? Alright, and there we go. There we go. That time I meant it. Alright, so these will go across here. And then these will go like this. Nope, it's gotta be. Well, actually, can I put that inside the block like that? Because it doesn't work right there. Well, hold on. Yeah, it doesn't reach there. And there, it's going into the block. So I don't know. You know what? It's still pretty low. All right, we're gonna put these one higher. Okay. Actually, that makes sense. It's 5. What, is it 5 high now? I kind of want it to be the same height as inside, so that's what I should be striving for. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 inside, the 5th is where the wall is going to be, or the ceiling. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is actually perfect. We're going to make that work one way or another. Let's commit. All right, let's get the concrete off it so we don't accidentally use it. Or we could just use it here. Let's just use it down here then. Yeah, this is a much better idea. Alright. Do I have steel on me? I do not, so we can just hold the button down. Oh, no, we can't hold the button down. I don't want to go to reinforced concrete. I mean, I'm going to go to reinforced concrete eventually, but only when, you know, we've gone all around the entire place. Because what we're doing right now, putting it from cobblestone to concrete, is doubling the hit points. Okay. So now we don't have any concrete on us. We don't have to worry about it. We could just hold down the button for the cobblestone. How does that look? Yeah, I like it. I like it. We just have to worry about the roof, but one problem at a time, right? Alright guys, unfortunately I was going to continue building this entire thing, But I can't really do that because it's nighttime, and once the day rolls over to day 14, I don't like logging off. I like to stay on for the entire day 14, so my hordes don't get bugged. So we are gonna have to call this one now. I'm not quite finished with the tower, but we got the walkways done. We got a lot of stuff done today. So anyway, that's gonna be it for episode 9. We'll see you next time for episode 10. Till then, take it easy.